Hi friends, let's study D6 to D11. These are quite straight and simple ones. The issuance date of MTD will be deemed to be the date of the receipt, dispatch, taking in charge or shipment on board and the date of shipment unless it bears a separate dated notation evidencing receipt, dispatch, taking in charge or shipment on board from the place, port or airport stated in the credit. It means in this stamp, there is a separate stamp of onboard, but the date is not given. So in this case, this issuance date will be treated as the date of issuance or date of loading. In the latter event, it means in this case, when this stamp contains onboard date also, then such date will be deemed to be the date of shipment, whether the date is before or after the issuance date of the MTD. It means even this date March 9th is before date of issuance, it will be considered as date of the shipment. A separate dated notation may also be indicated in the designated field or box. It means somebody can write year also onboard date or year also onboard date, wherever port of loading it can write over year also or year also onboard date separately. See, here simple logic is anywhere onboard date is given separately, then that date is to be considered, not the date of issuance. D7. When a credit requires a shipment to commence from a port, when the first leg of the journey, as required by the credit, is by sea, a MTD is to indicate a dated onboard notation, and in this event, paragraph E6, B2D will also apply, means this regards to BL. Sir, here is a chart. If the credit requires first leg to be by sea, then MTD plus BL would be applicable. If it is not by sea, first leg, any other mode, then only MTD would be applicable. D8. In a MTD, when a credit requires shipment to commence from a port, the named port of loading should appear in the... For more videos, you can follow our paid version. For paid version, you can WhatsApp us on this number. The videos are shared with you on a drive, and then once you have downloaded, then you can watch them without internet. You can keep them for lifetime. See here, these videos of CDCS are not only important for your exams, but throughout your career in trade finance, these videos would be useful to you. You can also download YuvaGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, test, question banks with explanations, job openings directly on your mobiles. You can follow us on Facebook on this link. Now, how many videos are there? See here, ISBP, it's 76 videos. In fact, daily or monthly new updations are done. UCP, 57 videos. General videos means other than all these UCP, ISP, ISBP, URR and EUCP, 55 videos. Then EUCP 12 videos, URR 27 videos, ISP 67 videos. Now remember one thing, all these videos cover the latest versions of all these 5 things, basically 5 books. To be more precise, ISBP 745, UCP 600, EUCP 1.1, URR 725 and ISP 98. As and when the editions are changed, the videos are changed accordingly. So you need not worry about that. Also, there are 500 plus questions with explanations and correct answers. So your explanations are very important so that you understand why the answer is whatever it is given. It also includes doc check case studies similar to that of in-basket and standalone and simulation exercises. Plus, real-time solutions are given on WhatsApp also. You have practice tests available on the app, so you can try that also. First thing you need to do is WhatsApp on this number to get the paid version, because on this app you will be needing internet, and if you take the paid version you don't need any internet. So keep studying, keep watching.